Are you interested in ultrasound? Well, if you are, my name is Abby, and I'm a class of 2024 graduate of the Diagnostic Medical Sonography program here at USI. Located on the third floor of the Health Professions building, this bachelor's program offers a wide range of didactic, laboratory, and clinical experiences in three concentrations to prepare students for their future career. We have a classroom size for 12 students and a lab holding 6 machines. These assets help students learn everything they need to know before heading to clinical. This program is also KHEP accredited, which means it provides all the necessary educational foundations needed for students to be successful. And I'll tell you what, because ultrasound is such a high demand career, most students have a job lined up before they even graduate. To add on, you'll get to have a close and personal relationship with your instructors. I'll introduce you to some as I head into their offices. Here we have our three concentration clinical coordinator and cardiac instructor, Jordan Thomason, clinical assistant professor and vascular clinical coordinator, Dr. Kathy Peake, and then right next door, our program chair director and clinical professor, Amy Wilson. You will see them quite often as they work together to teach abdomen, OBGYN, and your choice of cardiac or vascular. As you can tell, scanning babies is not the only thing we do, and that is the biggest misconception most people have. We can scan other things like the liver, gallbladder, kidneys, veins, arteries, and the heart. So if you'd like to join the program, here are some things you need to know about the admission process. After completing 2 semesters of prerequisites and holding a minimum GPA of a 3.0, you are eligible to apply. Every fall, the program admits 12 students to live out their passion for ultrasound, and I really wouldn't be too alarmed by that number because even though it's competitive, you'll have multiple chances to win over the faculty. After submitting your online application, you will turn in your narrative that will touch on observation experiences, what you see as essential traits to be an ultrasound tech, your long-term goals, and what your preferred discipline will be for your 4th year, whether that be cardiac or vascular. Once that is submitted, it is highly recommended that you turn in your observation log of at least 20 hours. The final step is the interviews. You'll be introduced to other faculty and clinical instructors that are excited to get to know you. Make sure they get to know who you are and how passionate you are about being an ultrasound tech. Not only that, but our instructors are always looking for individuals who are eager to learn, are willing to make the commitment, and have a general understanding of ultrasound. Let's hear what some of our faculty have to say.
So my first piece of advice would be during observation hours, we talk lots and lots about observation hours, but observing in every specialty. So there's lots of different specialties within sonography, and knowing all the different specialties and which one the student would want to choose their senior year. My second piece of advice would be pay attention in your RAD 196 class. I know that students sometimes might get bored in that class, but there's a lot of great information. So be sure to pay close attention to all that information. And then my third piece of advice is come see us in our lab. So we open the lab for students to come in and observe who want to get into the sonography program. And in our lab, you can see the one-on-one, hands-on experience that the students get with the instructors.
I would say come see us, come talk to us. We have 3 faculty members that teach full-time in the program, and I think we can give you some really good advice to potentially better your chances of being accepted into the program just by doing a couple things or tweaking a couple things. You know, we look at GPA of your prerequisite courses for admission into the program, and sometimes retaking a course that you got a C in, especially if it's a 4-credit hour course like a math or science course, retaking that and getting a B could have a really big impact in your prerequisite GPA. And then one of the other things too that I think is probably the second most important thing to do when thinking about applying to the program is to complete observation hours, and we can actually give you some suggestions on where to do those observation hours, but I think it's really important that you get a good feel for what the profession is like and a really good understanding of what the profession's like before you apply to the program, because in the end, if you're accepted into the program, we want to keep you. We don't want you to come in, be in the program for 6 months, and then decide this is not what I thought it was. We want you to see all aspects of what the profession is like, so we can give you some good ideas of where to go to complete those observation hours.
I have a couple of pieces of advice for students who are trying to get into the program. First of all, I would say really pay attention when you're doing observation. Make sure that you ask the supervising sonographers a lot of questions. I think it's important to take notes and write down the kind of things that you see. You know, don't be afraid to inquire about what their job is like, what kind of things they like, what kind of things that they don't like. And remember that any notes that you take, you can also use those notes during the interview process too. You can bring that notebook with you. So that might serve as an aid for you to help you remember some of the things you saw during observation. And my second piece of advice would be to really utilize all the resources that are available to you on campus. Use the writing lab to help you perfect your essay that you write for the program. Use career services or use your advisor to conduct mock interviews to help you become comfortable with the interview process. Make sure that you go meet some of the faculty members and meet some of the clinical instructors when you do your observation. And I think all of those things will help you feel more comfortable with the process.
Awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I don't know about you guys, but their advice is so crucial. Here's what I grabbed. Make sure you get the chance to observe all specialties to get a feel of what you like and to see if ultrasound is for you. Take as many notes as you can while you observe and try to even observe in the current student's lab. If you are unsure about your GPA, go ahead and retake the class to better it. You should meet the faculty as they would love to get to know you before your interviews. And then always utilize USI's resources. If you have any more questions about the program, make sure to check out our website for more information. You'll be able to find the contact information for our faculty members on there if you want to get in touch. Thank you guys for your time, and I hope you consider ultrasound for your future.